Hello everyone, my name is Chandrasekhar Patil. I would be starting the webinar now. So to start with, regarding the introduction of Manupatra is a company which started in 2001. Manupatra is driven by natural language processing, analytics, artificial intelligence, visualization tools, extensive hyperlinking to judgments, acts, rules, notifications. Compared to this, other tools are basically on searches, but we are a hardcore research tool and not a tool to take printouts only. So I will start with the legal updates. Being updated is very important in the legal profession. And we have various updates which we provide you on a regular basis. To start with, I would like to show you regarding the mobile app. We have mobile app on Android and iOS. You can download this, and once you download, you'll get a alert for enabling notifications. If you enable notifications, you'll get alerts on your mobile twice in a day regarding news alerts. This would be from various sources, and it would be a one-liner or two-liner message to you. This is on your mobile. Then we also have another option for your laptop. One is desktop alert. If you download this small app from this location, you would be able to see a small window on your desktop, which would alert you regarding news alerts whenever you are online. This is desktop alert. Another option you have, if you do not want a desktop thing, you want a alert on your web page, you have Chrome alert. If you click on this, you'll go to Chrome extension, and that gets added here on the Chrome page. If you click the Manupatra icon on the Chrome, you'll get to see the notifications. This is the second option what you have for the desktop alert. Then we have weekly news alerts, for which you have to subscribe clicking on subscribe to e-newsline. This is a weekly email alert which comes to you every Monday, which will have updates on what has happened in last 1 week on Supreme Court judgments, High Court judgments, notification circulars, international case laws, bills in parliament, and news alerts, all in one mail. So you can subscribe from this location. Then we also have podcast. Download any podcast app on your mobile and subscribe to Manupatra alerts there. So you can listen to Manupatra alerts on the move. So you don't have to read it, you just put your headphones and listen to it. Then we also recently started our Telegram channel. So you will have to download Telegram, search for Manu Patra channel and join that. Once you join that, you'll have regular updates on your Telegram. So this is about legal updates. You can choose whatever you're convenient on this. Let me log in now to Manu Patra and talk to you about business policy. Manu Patra is not just a case law search website. We also have various contents. So we have a section called business policy, which you can see on the left-hand side of the table of contents. I'll take you through this section. We have various subject-wise topics, starting with anti-dumping. You have introduction on anti-dumping and WTO, anti-dumping legislations. Basically, what we have in business policy is we have subject-wise content. Whatever we have on Manu Patra in various sections, we have divided this in subject-wise, plus more information relating to that particular subject. So you have everything related to anti-dumping in this particular section. I'll show you regarding corporate laws. Like for example, you have central acts on corporate laws. All the acts relating to corporate laws will be available here. You can click on any of the acts and view that. Then you have rules and regulations on corporate laws. All the rules would be available here. Then you have regulations. Then you have state acts. Then you have state rules and regulations. You have statutory forms. You have company law procedures. If, for example, I want to see the company law procedures as per Companies Act 2013, I click on this and I get to see all the procedures. Procedures for appointment of a director. Insolvency and bankruptcy code procedures. You have directions and guidelines. You have drafts and bills in Parliament relating to this act, you can see. You have ordinances also in that same section. You have schemes and orders. You can see so much we provide in one particular section regarding a particular topic. You have articles. You have due dates and penalties as per the Act. So which section, what is the offense and what is the punishment with a remark. Resolutions. So you have the templates for these resolutions. You have other relevant information. Month-wise compliance schedule. This is on a monthly basis. What are the compliance for income tax, labor laws, GST, all that is given here. You have NCLT, orders, notification and rules, committee reports, various committee reports which have been published, all that are available here. Most of these contents are available also in the main section, like bare acts are also available in the bare act section. Committee reports relating to only companies is available here. The main section would cover all subjects. Then you have annual reports. Limited liability partnership, details about that. Then you have Indian accounting standards, secretarial standards, auditing standards, concept papers, and frequently asked questions. So this is about corporate laws. This way you would have capital market, competition laws, consumer laws, cyber and IT laws. The same thing again, you will have the acts, bills, rules and regulations, notifications, everything related to that. So you have the cyber and IT laws. Then you have IPR. You have the case studies. You have employment laws, labor and industrial and service. Minimum wages and state notifications. Then you have on service. Then you have Forex and banking. Then you have Indian industrial policies. Human rights. Foreign trade policy and procedures. Environment. From notification from Ministry of Environment. Then you have sections for insolvency. Insurance, international laws, then you have media and communication. Mines and minerals. Power and energy. Then you have the last, real estate. The acts, state acts, drafts, all that. Smart city schemes. This is about business policy. This is the content what we cover in this section. So the next thing what I will be covering is article search. We have recently started a search on articles. So this would be a custom Google search where we have listed around 300 plus open source websites. And whatever you search here, it would give you results only out of those 300 plus websites which are open source. So let me show it to you. How do you search here? Let me try human rights and refugee. You have to click on this yellow color icon to do a article search instead of clicking on the search icon on the top. This yellow color page icon will take you to various results, like for example, first result what we have got. If I click on that, you would get the results. You can read this content. So let me show you another example. So you'll be getting various results here. Then move to the mesh page as per your interest. So this is article search. For this, you will have to go to Manu search, then type in what you will want to search and click on this yellow color icon. Then we will start with visualization tools. I will take you through various cases. Where I would show you, first we will search for Minerva Mills case. I have opened this judgment. You can see various icons on your right hand side. So today I would be explaining you about these two icons. One is interactive timeline authority check, the second is case map. Interactive timeline authority check is a very important feature. If you are very much interested in looking for other judgments apart from the Minerva Mills case, you want to see which are the related cases. So it's just one single graph. It is showing you all the cases where Minerva Mills case has been referred or cited. So it is a graph which shows court wise and year wise index. So you can see various circles. All these circles denote individual cases. So you have in total 408 cases. So if I want, I have an option to reduce the graph to minimum results as I want. I can also see cases which have only been relied. So here you can see various colors being shown. Green is for relied, red is for dissented, gray is for mentioned, discussed, distinguished and affirmed. If a case is just mentioned, then the circle will be gray. If it is relied, it is green. And you can also see the size of the circle is differing. If I take to this circle, this is a judgment of Ravi Yashwant. This case has been further cited 308 times. So the size of the circle is bigger. If I take, you can see another circle within that circle. Within that same period, you have another judgment, Namit Sharma case, where this has been discussed and that case has been further cited 118 times. So you can basically see which is a judgment which is cited more number of times, where Minerva Mills case has been cited. And you can also see the complete graph clicking on all. So this is for Minerva Mills case, the timeline authority check. This will help you in finding many other cases which are relevant to be cited. Then the second feature is the case map. So this feature has up to 20 cases in a graphical representation. On the gray side, on the left hand side, what you see are the cases which have been cited in Minerva Mills case. So you can see the arrow mark coming in. So, and on the right hand side, you have 10 more cases where Minerva Mills case has been cited in those cases. So the arrow mark going out. So you can see also the correlation. The yellow color means that judgment has been discussed. This would be mentioned. This would be dissented. So the correlation is being shown. So now, how do I know which are the other cases which are suggested to be read along with Minerva Mills case without even opening the case? So if you take the cursor to any of those circles, in this you can see two more judgments which have been cited apart from Minerva Mills case, which is Keshavananda Bharti case and Indira Gandhi case. If I take to this circle, you have more cases coming up. So totally around 5 cases. So more, this case you can see has been dissented when it was cited. You have two more judgments which have also been dissented when they were cited. So it is better avoid this case. So always go with a case which has more references. See, this is also another case where it is dissented. So avoid cases. This is one of the cases which can be read along with that. You can also try on the other side. So you can see up, this case has been referred in Minerva Mills case, and 5 other cases which have been mentioned in Minerva Mills case has been referred in this case. So you can read that case also. So this is a graph which is called case map, which will help you save your time by not opening all the cases but suggesting you which all cases have to be read along with the case which you have opened. Let us try some other case. We'll look for case where the appellant or respondent is Patel Engineering. So this is one of the landmark cases, SBP and Company versus Patel Engineering. The same thing, if I open the timeline authority check, here there are 842 cases which have been, where this case has been cited, the Patel Engineering case has been cited. So you can see various circles. This is the line where Supreme Court judgments it is cited in. At the bottom, you have other courts apart from the courts which have been mentioned above. So again, you have this option. If I want to see only dissented cases, you can see the various dissented cases here. If you want to read these cases, you will have to take down the appellant or respondent and go to legal search and search for it. Or you can also take down the Manupatra citation and search for it. This will help you go to that judgment. The hyperlinking is not given because these many judgments opening simultaneously might hang your screen. So the hyperlinking is not option which is available on this particular feature. You can see this judgment has been further cited 6 times. This judgment is further cited 15 times. Where Patel Engineering case has been relied. So let's go to the case map option. So again, you see 10 cases on the left hand side and 10 cases on the right hand side. As I mentioned, left hand side cases are the cases which have been cited in the center case, and the Patel Engineering case has been cited on the right hand side cases. These are the top 20 cases as per our software. So if I take the cursor, you can see apart from Patel Engineering case, there's another Konkan Railway case which I've been cited. This is a case where it was dissented. You have this case where 4 more cases have been cited. So this is the way it will help you find other judgments which are relevant and which can also save you time in looking for it. Let me do another search. On Islamic Academy judgment. This is a case which has been overruled, but still just take you through the feature. This is timeline graph. The various judgments, green, gray, and red circles. As I earlier mentioned, you can limit the number of graphs and also limit the judgments what you want to view. Then we have case map option. You can see cases which have been relied. This is being shown as overruled, as the flag was being showed in the search result. Here the same things what I showed you in previous this judgment. The above two judgments, TMA Pi judgment and Islamic Academy, has been dissented. This judgment, you can see so many judgments being referred there. So you can read those cases apart from the case what you are currently reading. So let me show you another feature, which is legal analytics. Here we have search analytics. In search analytics, it will show you top 50 cases in a graphical representation. It will not show you list of cases, but it will show you list of cases in a graph. So fundamental right to speech, I just type fundamental right and speech. Okay, I get plenty of circles here. Each circle denote a particular judgment. A blue color circle is a Supreme Court judgment. A green color is a High Court judgment. So if I take the cursor, you can also see the graph shown year wise, starting with 1950, 2010 and above. If I take the cursor to any of these circles, it will show me that particular case, K. Abbas versus Union of India case, is cited in which all cases. You can see the latest case where this case is cited is this Subramaniam Swamy case versus Union of India. If I want to know more about this case, I do a single click. I will get to know how many times this case has been further cited. This case is cited 59 times. And how it was treated when it was cited. All that you can see. Then you can see which are the keywords used in this judgment. Which are the acts and rules referred in this case. So it will give you a brief idea about this case. Then you want to read this complete judgment. Click on results on the top. And go to that particular. This being on the top, I can just click here. I can read the complete judgment. As I told you in the timeline authority check, we don't have the hyperlinking. But in this, we have the hyperlinking. I just have to click on any particular circle to go to that judgment. Let's try another search. You're searching for general justice and judgments on that. So you have got various blue circles. You can see the top in the top 50 case, it's giving me Vishakha versus State of Rajasthan as one of the relevant cases. So this judgment, you can see, has been cited 464 times. And you can also see where all this case has been cited. If I want to read any of these cases, I just click on that circle and open that judgment. Even here, as I mentioned earlier, the size of the circle depends on how many times that particular judgment has been cited in other cases. Bigger the circle, more number of times it is cited. Smaller the circle, less number of times it's cited. You can see this judgment has been cited 6 times. Let's try another search. Contract labor. This judgment is cited 458 times. You can also see how this judgment was treated when it was cited. Citing reference, keywords, and acts referred in this case. If you want to read the judgment, click on the results icon. Click on which judgment you want to read and open that case. So this is search analytics. Then we have another feature in analytics called the judge analytics. Most of you would agree understanding the judge before you appear before him would be very important. So you would want to know how many judgments he's authored, how many judgments he's authored on a particular topic, all that. So I would take you through certain judges. Here you have a list of all the judges of Supreme Court and High Court. You can select whichever High Court you want and view those judges also. So it will show you how many judgments they have written. How out of these, so for example, A.N. Venugopal Gowda has written 1097 results, sorry, judgments. Out of those judgments, 629 judgments have been cited in other cases. So let's go with a search. Let me show you regarding Justice Deepak Mishra. You have got various graphs. The first graph will show you judgments which he has authored versus part of bench. So before his retirement in 2018, he has authored 39 judgments. If I click on that number, I will get to read all those 39 cases. And these are the judgments which he is part of bench, which has not been authored but authored by a co-judge. So this is about judgments which have been authored and part of bench. The second graph would show you the subjects which he has taken up number wise. He has given more judgments on criminal, then it would be civil, then service. So if I want to view judgments of Deepak Mishra on constitution, I directly click on this number and I would be able to read those judgments. In Supreme Court, we have this option where you can also go through which are the counsels who have appeared more number of times before this particular judge. So most of the times, being a high court lawyer or trial court lawyer, you have to give cases to Supreme Court lawyers. You can see this and before which particular judge you have the case, you can see which lawyer has appeared more number of times. And you can read a couple of his cases to understand it. So it will help you make your decisions easier. Then we have disposition pattern of the judge. He has allowed 138 cases, dismissed 113, disposed of 66, partly allowed 23, in favor of department 14. You click on more, you get more options. I want to see these cases. So you can click on any of these judgments and read. These are all hyperlinked. Most of the lawyers who have experience sometimes avoid going before a particular bench because of this reason, where dismissal rate of a particular judge is very high. They avoid going before that particular bench. They wait for the bench to change. This is our experience, or which people do. But here we are giving you the numbers which you can think of. Then we have judge cited. Deepak Mishra has cited which judge in his case. On the top you can see S.B. Sinha, then Arjit Pasayat, then Deepak Mishra himself. So you can see which cases he himself has cited, or the counsels who have referred his case before him. Those judgments can be read. Then Deepak Mishra has been cited by which judges. That list you can see here. Then you have these two graphs at the end, which show how were Deepak Mishra's cases treated when it was cited in Supreme Court and High Court. You can see which are the cases which got dissented when it was cited. These are the cases which got dissented when it was cited in some other case. Which are the cases which got affirmed? This is about Deepak Mishra. You can also search, for example, if I want to search your murder, it will search in the cases which have been authored by Deepak Mishra. You can open those cases and go through those cases. So this is a search within the authored cases only. Let's do a search on the existing judge D.Y. Chandrachud. So you have the graph again here. If you want to search, you have the option here in its authored cases. The above, what we are mentioning, is the period when he started in Supreme Court and what is his retirement year. The first graph, as I mentioned to you earlier, talks about judgments which he has authored and part of bench. Judgments which have been authored helps in understanding the judge better compared to part of bench. Most of the other tools would not give you this option where it's authored, not, you can't filter that. Then judgments pronounced, he has pronounced more judgments on service. So sometimes even counsels, if they find a single bench, a single judge who is experienced on some other topic, he has come as a interim judge or a vacation bench judge, they would avoid moving the case before him because he is not an expert in that particular subject. Then you have counsels who have appeared more number of times. This feature, counsels who have appeared more number of times before a particular judge, is not available in the High Court feature. Apart from that, all other features are available. In the High Court judges list, you don't have the counsels who have appeared before a particular judge. You can see appeal allowed 100, dismissed 41, in favor of state 11, partly allowed 8. So you can click on more to find more options. Then which all cases he has referred, which judges cases he has referred in his judgments. Who has referred his cases, which other justices have referred his cases, and how are his judgments treated when cited in other cases, in Supreme Court and High Court. So this is regarding the search on judge. So I have searched for retirement and I get this judgment of 1st April 2020 where the word is mentioned in this case. So this is about all the features what I've taken you through, starting from the legal updates, business policy. Then we had the case map and interactive timeline graph, the visualization tools. Then we had the search analytics and judge analytics. So if you have any questions, you can ask me. Hello. Pradhuman, you can speak.
Hello.
Hello. Yeah, yeah. I can hear you.
Okay. I wanted to know two things actually. So the first is how do you do sticky notes?
Sticky note is available on another webinar. I will just tell you. Go to any of the judgments, and then you have a sticky note icon. Just click on that, and you can do from there. It was not covered in this webinar. So you can also, you have another option is on Manupatra page. You click on training. You have videos there. So that video will tell you how to use sticky note.
Okay. And the second thing was in this legal analytics, this search thing, can you do advanced those techniques are there, no? Those you use keywords and then the judgment comes. So can you?
As I showed you, you can do a search, basic search where you have authored cases. You want more advanced features, you can do like multiple options and all. You can do it in legal search where you have you can fill in the judge as well as other things.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, Parth. Hello.
Am I audible?
Yeah, you are.
Okay. So you showed one judgment on Islamic Academy.
Yes.
It was dissented, right? So where can we see?
It was overruled.
Yeah, overruled. Sorry, you overruled. So where can we see which judgment has overruled it?
In the same judgment also you can see it is mentioned there, overruled by which judgment, in the same judgment, or in the search result itself you have a red color flag on the right hand side. You click on the red color flag, it will take you to the judgment which has overruled that judgment.
Okay.
Any other questions?
No.
Thank you. Yes, Mr. Ghosh. Yeah, Mr. Ghosh. Hello.
Hello, am I audible?
Yeah, you are.
Hello, sir. In the case map, you had given that, you had shown that there are only 20 cases which can be shown.
It is the top 20 relevant cases as per our software.
Okay. So then what about the other cases which have been referred in that case? How
that
do I
you
get
can see in that you get in the timeline authority check I showed you all other cases, no? Where
right,
this
sir.
Case has been cited.
Okay.
And if you want to see which cases have been cited in that case, you can go to the judgment. There all the cases which have been referred are already there.
Okay. I got it. Yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
This ends the session. Thanks a lot for your time. Thank you.